Hello from Aswan. My name is Halil and I'll be your guide to this amazing city. Join me as I explore the temples of Philae in Abu Simbel, take a Felucca ride on River Nile, and share my experiences from this beautiful city. Welcome to Aswan. Right now we are leaving our hotel and heading out to explore Aswan. This is our first day here, so I'm really excited for what's coming next. So, let's explore Aswan together. Let's go. We are now in front of Philae Temple. We're gonna head there now by motorboat. So just a quick information about Philae Temple. You have to buy two tickets, one for the entrance and one for the boat. Both of them are around $10. Okay, see you my friend, thank you. So now we arrived in Philae Temple. This temple was actually dedicated to the goddess of healing, Isis. And it was actually one of the last remaining ancient temples of Egypt. It was later closed by the Roman Empire. This place was actually about to be flooded by the River Nile, but thanks to UNESCO's help, it got actually saved, and thanks to that we can now walk between these columns and see this place in one piece. So thanks for that, UNESCO, because this place is awesome. Right, we are now back on the boat and heading back to Aswan. As the Temple of Philae is located on an island, you have to come by boat and leave by boat. So now we are heading back to our second location in Aswan, Nubian Village. Stay tuned.
Yalla Habibi!
Transportation here, I fixed the price with a local driver, so he's taking us everywhere during today. So this is also an advice I would give to you: find a local and fix a price for the whole day and travel anywhere you want. And we have arrived in our second location in Aswan, Nubian Village, and we're going to be having our lunch here, and then we're going to start to wander around and I'll show you how this village looks like and share my experiences with you. So stay tuned. Our food has arrived and it looks amazing. We only ordered two meals actually, and they brought us all of these as a complimentary food, and it looks so nice. So I'll just dig in now and I'll see you after the lunch.
Bon appetit.
Bon appetit. Thank you, have a nice day. So now we are heading out of the restaurant and starting to wander around in Nubian Village. Let's see how it looks like here. So Nubian people are weaving headscarves here. And Celine is also trying out now to learn how it is done.
Switch, left.
Left?
Press, yes.
Oh yeah.
Back again.
Push it. No, game over.
I'm sorry for that.
Yeah. Not the best weaver out there, huh?
You have to push it straight.
How was the experience?
That was terrible for me to ruin it. But it was.
Where are you from?
Turkey.
Turkey, welcome. Atatürk.
Thank you. Yeah. You're the man. Atatürk always.
Yes.
Thank you, my friend. Thank you for everything. The streets are full of shops. You can get souvenirs from here and some spices as well. So the culture here is different than that of Egyptian peoples, because the people here come from Sudan.
Hola,
Maria. Hola.
Donde?
Turkey.
Yavaş yavaş.
And when people hear that I'm from Turkey, they really get happy about it. I don't know the reason, but I think it's probably because of the Ottoman Empire. We had some similar roots.
Now, round the sun.
This guy just turned sands into pictures. Incredible. So your name is Pablo Picasso.
I'm Pablo Picasso.
Nice to meet you.
Yes. Nice Picasso in sand.
Yeah. Now you're really an artist.
Yes.
This looks really good. Nice, my friend.
Yeah, that's so nice, so cute.
Yes.
Where are you from?
Turkey.
Merhaba. Have a nice day, my friend. Look at this little fellow here. What's your name?
I'm Rayan.
Rayan. You? Ahmed. You?
Muhammad.
Rayan. Ahmed. Muhammad. Nice to meet you. Are these your dogs?
Yes.
Ah, they're beautiful. As you see, there are some boats here. You can take a ride from Aswan till here. You can also go back by the same boat back to Aswan. Well, I just want to add that there are some accommodation options here too. You can book an hotel or a house, guest house, hostel, and stay here as well. This is one of those Nubian houses where you can stay. I just wanted to show you. Oh, look at them. They're swimming over there. Thank you, my friend. He knows we are from Turkey, that's why he brought us a Turkish coffee. Nice. So they treated us hibiscus juice, which is local here. And the Nubian people are so nice, you know. I'm not surprised. The Egyptian people are really nice in general, but the people here are, you know, always smiling. They're always inviting. They're very friendly. I mean, they might be my favorite people in whole Egypt. So now we are heading to ride camels.
See you, my friend.
Adios. Adios. One more activity you can do in Aswan is riding a camel in a desert. Right now we are really close to Nubian village, and there's a desert next to it. We're gonna be taking a ride on this fella and enjoy desert. It's actually a bit higher than I guessed, but still a fun experience. But if you ask me if I ever do it again, I'm not sure. And he agrees. So in front of me you see the River Nile, and behind me you see the Sahara Desert. And we are doing a safari with our camel friend here. And also my friend, what's your name?
Mohammed.
Mohammed here. And we had a great experience in the desert on a camel. It was really nice to ride a camel in the desert. It was a bit difficult to get on and off, but overall it's a nice experience. Now we are getting on a boat and we are going back to Aswan. So we're gonna be taking this boat back to Aswan. The rooftop looked amazing, that's why we're gonna be doing it here, and we're going to be watching the sceneries that we see along the River Nile. So let's go and enjoy this beautiful place together. Let's go. The views that you see along the river is amazing. So definitely add this to your list and enjoy River Nile. By the way, our hotel is next to River Nile. Actually here. So we're gonna be getting off here and just chill a little bit, and then we're gonna go outside and explore the bazaar of Aswan. So we get off here, and here we are at our hotel. Right now we are in Aswan Sok, and this is probably the biggest and the oldest bazaar in Aswan. If you wanna buy souvenirs, this is the place where you can buy souvenirs for cheaper prices. Now we're gonna take a tour here and I'll show you how it looks like. Let's go.
Yavaş yavaş, Hasan şaş.
Now we're gonna try some Egyptian street food. The name of the food is called fahira. So let's try it.
Mm.
This is really nice. And this is called zelabi, and we're gonna try it as well. Let's see. And this is zelahiye with some chocolate toppings. Now we're gonna try it. Mmm, it's sweet. So I just got back from the bazaar. It was a nice experience to, you know, just talk to the locals, enjoy some local dishes, and wander around in bazaar. It was a nice experience. But tomorrow we are heading out to a temple called Abu Simbel. It takes around 3 hours just to get there, but it's a huge temple, and I think it's one of the best in the whole Egypt. So I think it will be worth it, even if it takes my whole day. So stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you in the morning. Good morning. Right now I am heading to Abu Simbel temple. It will take us like 34 hours to get there, but I think it will worth it. I booked a private car because all other tour companies leave at 4 a.m. in the morning. That's why it is really crowded early in the morning. So I'll see you there. My guide here tells me that if you came here early in the morning, you would have around 5,000 people.
This is the end of the tour. This is the end of the season. A couple of weeks ago, it was more than 7,000 people each day.
Wow. So early in the morning, it's so dense, crowded, right?
From 6 o'clock until 11 o'clock, this is the busy time.
Busy time. It says this is the best time if you don't mind the sun. The best time to visit Egypt, if you ask me, would be between February and April. Because it's not that cold, it's not that hot, it's in between. So we're about to enter Abu Simbel. We're going to be getting our tickets. The lake behind me is called Nasir. It is the biggest lake made by men. It's around 500 kilometers and 350 kilometers is in Egypt. The rest, 150 kilometers, is in Sudan. And it's also dangerous to swim inside because there are crocodiles inside. So I wouldn't recommend it. Okay, we got our tickets. It's around $10 for the entrance. The statues that you see here are actually all King Ramses II. The one on the left shows his early age, the one on the right shows his adulthood, and the one on the right, far right, is his old age. All right, we are now entering the temple, and it is empty. My plan worked out. There is actually an astronomical importance of this place too. Two times in a year, the sun rays hit on these statues, but just two times. The first one happens on the 22nd of February, and the second one happens on the 22nd of October. And the one in the February is actually for celebrating the cultivation agriculture, and the second one is for the flooding of River Nile. We are now in front of the small temple of Abu Simbel, which was dedicated to Ramses II's wife. He made this temple for her, But there are six statues here. Only two of them belongs to the famous queen of Nefertari. The other four are of Ramses's. This guy must have loved himself. Look, Ramses, Nefertari, Ramses, Ramses, Nefertari, and at the end, Ramses again. On the walls of this temple, we see the Great War Kadesh. It's actually what made the king Ramses II the greatest emperor of all times in Egypt. What I want to show you something which I think is also related to the film industry. The first ever animation in history is displayed here. You see, the horse has four legs here as well to give the animation feeling of the horse. We are now running out of the temple because we have a plane to catch back in Aswan. But as you see, it's definitely worth visiting here. Our flight is at 8 and right now time is 3:30 and the path takes like 4 hours. So we're a bit late, as you can guess. I made it to the airport and I'll be flying back to Cairo and from there back to Istanbul. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please like, comment and subscribe to my channel for more of these contents. And I'll see you in my next video. Take care.